Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Were there white people in antiquity? Certainly some assume so, as the categories we use today could be read backwards over the millennia. People with light skin certainly existed well before our own times. But did anyone think they were white, or that their character related to their color? No. For neither the idea of race nor the idea of white people had been invented. And people's skin color did not carry useful meaning. What mattered was where they lived. Were their lands damp or dry? Were they virile or prone to impotence, hard or soft? Could they be seduced by the luxuries of civilized society, or were they warriors through and through? What were their habits of life? Rather than as white people, Northern Europeans were known by vague tribal names: Scythians and Celts, then Gauls and Germany. But if one asks, say, who are the Scythians? The question sets us off down a slippery slope, for, over time and especially in earliest times, any search for the ancestors of white Americans perforce leads back to non-literate people who left no documents describing themselves. Thus, we must sift through the intellectual history Americans claim as Westerners, keeping in mind that long before science dictated the terms of human difference as race, long before racial scientists began to measure heads and concoct racial theory, ancient Greeks and Romans had their own means of describing the peoples of their world as they knew it more than two millennia ago. And inevitably, the earliest accounts of our story are told from on high, by rulers dominant at a particular time. Power affixes the markers of history. Furthermore, any attempt to trace biological ancestry quickly turns into legend, for human beings have multiplied so rapidly, by 1,000 or more times in some 200 years, and by more than 32,000 times in 300 years. Evolutionary biologists now reckon that the 6 to 7 billion people now living share the same small number of ancestors living 2 or 3,000 years ago. These circumstances make nonsense of anybody's pretensions to find a pure racial ancestry, nor are notions of Western cultural purity any less spurious. Without a doubt, the sophisticated Egyptian, Phoenician, Minoan, and Persian societies deeply influenced the classical culture of ancient Greece, which some still imagine as the West's pure and unique source. That story is still to come. For the obsession with purity, racial and cultural, arose many centuries after the demise of the ancients. Suffice it to say that our search for the history of white people must begin in the misty mixture of myth and reality that comprises ancient Greek literature. Early on, most Greek notions about peoples living along the northeastern border, especially that vaguely known place called the Caucasus, were mythological, known to Westerners since prehistoric times. The Caucasus is a geographically and ethnically complex area lying between the Black and Caspian Seas and flanked north and south by two ranges of the Caucasus Mountains. The northern Caucasus range forms a natural border with Russia. The southern, lesser Caucasus physically separates the area from Turkey and Iran. The Republic of Georgia lies between the disputed region of the Caucasus, Turkey, Armenia, Iran, and Azerbaijan. According to Greek mythology, Jason and his Argonauts sought the Golden Fleece in the Caucasus, land of Colchis, near the present-day Georgian city of Poti, obtaining it from King Aetes. thanks to the magical powers of the king's daughter, the Princess Medea. In Homer's Odyssey, Circe, the sister of King Aeetes, transforms half of Odysseus's men into animals and seduces Odysseus. Later on, Hesiod and Aeschylus take up the tale of Prometheus, son of a Titan, punished for having stolen the secret of fire from Zeus, who chains Prometheus to a mountain in the Caucasus and sends an eagle to peck at his liver every day for 30,000 years. One can see that to the Greeks. Almost anything goes on in the Caucasus. Furthermore, Greek mythology accords women of the Caucasus extraordinary powers, whether the magical of Medea and Circe, or the warlike of the Amazons, variously located in a number of places, including the Caucasus. Even today, these myths reverberate.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.